A man has undergone emergency surgery after Sydney's third suspected gangland shooting in a week. The 29-year-old had just returned home from work when he was ambushed by a gunman on a suburban street.
Nine last night and Nyland Crescent in Blackett is rocked by gunfire.
It was probably about six to eight shots, pretty loud and pretty quick.
I know the family was crying and everybody was screaming. They were saying somebody got shot.
The target, 29-year-old Michael Papu, ambushed by a gunman as he reversed his car into his driveway after a day at work.
There appears to be that the offenders may have had some knowledge of the movements of the victim prior to it.
His family and neighbours heard the shots. They ran out to find Michael peppered with bullets.
The family gave us a towel because I asked them for a towel. Yeah.
And what did you do with the towel?
Try to hold pressure down.
Hit in the head, neck and stomach, the victim, who isn't known to police, was taken to Westmead Hospital in a serious condition. Officers swarming the area to track down the shooter.
Witnesses say they saw a man run down this nearby alleyway shortly after the shooting. This path leads to a reserve that snakes its way through the suburb and on the other side, a local shopping centre car park.
A Kia SUV was found burnt out in bushland 25 minutes northwest in Agnes Banks, a suspected getaway car. Three shootings in 5 days, Bidwill, Campsie, now Blackett, has pressure mounting on police and politicians to bring gun violence under control.
At the moment, we haven't been able to establish any links to any other matters that have occurred recently.
It won't go unpunished. They do catch the perpetrators.
In Blackett, James Wilson, Nine News.